Hello friends, myself Ravi Shankar Kumar. So today we will learn about how we can use Angular Material button in our application. So in order to do that, first we will type Angular Material in Chrome. Open your Chrome browser, write Angular Material, go to this Angular Material, material.angular.io website. Click on this. You can see here we have component CDK guides. So click on component. After clicking on component, you can see lots of Angular Material elements are here in the left side panel. In this video, we will learn about button, how we can use button in our application. So click on button here. You can see we have different kinds of button here. If I scroll down also, there are different kinds of button that you can see as an example. So in order to implement it, first click on API. We need to copy this import statement for this material button module. So copy it and we will go to our VS Code. Here you can find app.module.ts. Click on that, paste this here, and if you see I have pasted it, copy this mat button module, and under this import section you need to paste it. So please paste it. Now we are good to implement the Angular Material button. So I will click on app component.html and now we will write some HTML for it. So suppose writing button, okay, we will give it a mat button. We will name it, suppose, right click, okay. So this button is now implemented. Now we will implement it, we will run our application and then we will see how it looks like, okay. So for that, type ng-serve in order to run the application. Enter. It will take couple of seconds to run this application, and after this we will go to our Chrome browser and see if Angular Material button is working or not. Okay, so if you see the compilation has started. So after this is done, we will go to our Chrome browser. You see compilation is successful. We will open localhost 4200. Okay, so for that first go to the Chrome browser, open localhost 4200. You see, now if you see this Angular button is working here, right? So we will try to style it a little bit, okay. So for that, let's again go to the VS Code, okay, and implement some styling. So suppose we give some styling, some background color that is violet, and suppose button color. Color I will give white. Okay, so you can also do some padding stuff. Do some padding, give it suppose 5 pixel, right? So now we will see this, how this styling looks on our button. Okay, so this is the custom styling that we have implemented. Okay, now let's go to Chrome and see how it looks like. Okay, so if I go to Chrome, if you see, right, the styling has been implemented here. Background color, the text color, all has been changed. Okay, again we will make some changes here, but for, before that I wanted to show you something. So go to here, overview. Okay, scroll down a little bit, and if you see, there are a lot of different kind of buttons here, but by using some keywords you can implement 4 to 5 colors here, which is primary, accent and word. If I want to see the code for it, click here. Okay, and you can see color, right? You see this color as primary, color as accent, color as worn, right? So these are the colors that you want to see, right? So let me implement it once again and we will see how it looks like. Okay, so for that we go to our VS Code again and we will make some changes. So let's go to VS Code, open VS Code. Now what we will do, we will remove this custom styling. Okay, we will copy these buttons. Okay, okay, and we will give color. Primary to first button. Okay, copy this, paste it for two different buttons. We will give accent, also we will give warning. Okay, now we will go to our Chrome browser and again see how it actually looks like on UI. Okay, so let's go. I will go to Chrome, open this demo app. If you can see here, we have 3 right clicks. Okay, but the color that we wanted to see is not here, right? So if you see, I have put that color equals to worn primary, but color is not working here, right? So there must be some problem. So what we will do, we will just inspect it, go to console. So if you see here, it is giving us some warning. What is that? Couldn't find Angular Material Core theme. Okay, so basically it is not able to find the Angular Material Core theme. That's why if we are using color equals to primary, it's not taking the text color as primary, right? So in order to fix that, we need to open our VS Code. Open the VS Code. Go to your style.css and import this thing. Import node modules and pre-built theme Angular Material. Okay, so basically after this import, using this import, you can see in the browser that the color will be working. Okay, so in order to see that, Now let's go to our Chrome browser. So let me open it. So if you see, right, the text color has been changed. So red for warn, ascent is yellow, and primary is blue theme. Okay, so that's how you implement your Angular material button. So that's it for this video, and if you haven't subscribed the channel, please subscribe the channel to get more updates of the videos. Thanks for watching.